ladies and gentlemen. I am Trisha with Insectopia, here to talk to you about the aquatic macroinvertebrates that live in your local creek, stream, river, or lake. These are animals that live in the water, can be seen with the naked eye, and have no backbone. There are a large number of species competing and trying to live in the same aquatic space. To decrease competition, each animal has their own job or niche in the system. This helps them live a balanced life with one another. Entomologists have assigned names to the jobs that these macroinvertebrates do. Let me introduce you to them. This is a cranefly larva and a caddisfly larva. They are shredders. It is their job to find large leaves and pieces of wood that have fallen into the water. They will eat off of them and shred these large pieces into smaller, more manageable pieces. These smaller pieces will get swept into the water column and continue down the stream. Next are the grazers. These are the snails and the mayflies. Their job is to travel along the substrate and rocks to eat the layer of algae and microorganisms. They will also rip algae off of rocks and send it downstream. That leaves it up to the gatherers to pick up the mess. This is a caddisfly larva and a stonefly larva. It is their job to travel on the substrate and scavenge for their food. They may find dead leaves, rotting wood, or dead organisms. The gatherers are generally not very picky and travel the substrate eating what they can find. This can be a messy job as smaller and more fine organic material gets passed down to our next animals. These are your friendly neighborhood filterers. They are the blackfly larva, net-spinning caddisfly, and the scud. These macroinvertebrates have a very important job. They will filter their food directly out of the water column and feed on the fine organic material that has been passed downstream by everyone else. They each have their own method of filtering the water. The blackfly larvae has labral fans that it will use to wave in the air and collect small particles for food. The net-spinning caddisfly doesn't expend its energy actively filtering particles. It finds a nice place on a rock that has a current and places a silk net to filter particles out of the water. They will then either graze off of their net or eat it completely and build a new one. The scud is an active swimmer and will swim through the water as it eats fine particles. I'm glad we have each of these macroinvertebrates living together harmoniously. There is only one job left, and it belongs to the dragonfly and damselfly nymphs. They are predators. Their job is to feed on other macroinvertebrates and keep their populations under control. No matter if you are in a small creek or a large river, about 20% of the population of macroinvertebrates will be predators. Each one of these jobs is important, and knowing them is key to understanding aquatic environments. A healthy stream will have a predictable assortment of these macroinvertebrates. Come back next week to learn more about these aquatic systems. Make sure to like and subscribe for more videos like this one. Come back soon and check out our next epic insect tale.